ago when I heard that they were doing the Johnny Cash story, I got very excited. I liked Johnny Cash. I'd done a couple of shows with Johnny Cash, met him several times. He was really a humble guy to talk to, had a great voice. He was pretty amazing. He toured with a guitar and Luther on, picking on a Telecaster guitar, just the two of them. Then he added a bass player, and they were called the Tennessee Two, and then after a while he added a drummer, they were called the Tennessee Three. But he always had a real honesty in his voice. And the first song I ever learned to play on guitar when I was about 14 was the song I Walk the Line. And then I was doing a jazz album, and I thought, gee, I'm going to do I Walk the Line, but I'm going to change it, not make it major chords. I'm going to sing it in minor chords and see how that sounds. And it sounded pretty cool. It sounded even more plaintive than the original one, Because You're Mine, I Walk the Line. So I did it in a minor key with some jazz musicians. It was pretty cool. I then tried to get it in the movie, and then I found out that the guy who was acting as Johnny, Joaquin Phoenix, was doing all the singing himself. I thought, wow, that's a pretty heavy thing. But he did a wonderful job, and I saw the movie and loved it, and it was quite fantastic. So I did the song basically to get it in the movie or to get airplay at the time, because the old Johnny Cash movie was coming out, and I never got either. But I did put it out on a jazz album, and a lot of people like it. So here's my own version from my jazz thing album, I Walk the Line. I keep a close watch on this part of the world. I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep my hands up for the tide that binds, because you're mine. I found myself alone on the distant. a couple of jazz guys. Joel Kroeger is the extra voice in there and the extra guitar. Now we're going to go to a guy who's had a wonderful career and he's still going, Joe Walsh. If you Google Joe Walsh on YouTube, you'll see some incredible videos. He tells how he writes the songs. He's very comedic the way he talks. He's a very funny, agreeable, happy guy. He's had an incredible life of excess and addiction, and he freely talks about overcoming all that. He's been sober now for 28 or 29 years, but in his wild years, along with Keith Moon from The Who, they were basically wanted by every police force in the world, in every city in the world. He started out in a Cleveland band called the James Gang, and he met his manager at that time, who was Irv Azoff, who managed him and Dan Fogelberg, and then he went on to have his own solo career as Joe Walsh. And then he went on to join Eagles because Irv Azoff joined Eagles, and Eagles had a guy who wanted to leave the band. Bernie Leadon didn't want to stay in the band. He really didn't like touring. So Joe Walsh joined, and he's been a member of the Eagles now for decades and a very integral part of the Eagles. He brings his own solo stuff, and he kind of brings the rock and roll guitar into the Eagles. There's one of his first songs, 1971, with the James Gang. It's called Walk Away.
Oh, yeah.
James Gang with Walk Away. Here's a gun.